My MBA journey, hello, my name is Angelo Rossi, and I'm here to talk about my MBA journey. The goals I had coming into here, where I was looking to get out of it, why I started this process, was better understanding of accounting. I have my BS is in finance. I wanted to get a better understanding of the accounting role, maybe possibly one day sit for the CPA exam, and I thought the best way to start would be to get my MBA. The other way was to better my career. As I look through the job market and send in resumes, I see that every job would like or requires an MBA. I think as time goes by and years go, MBAs are going to be required for most of professional careers and jobs that I'm looking for. The last one was to take advantage of an employee benefit. At the time I was working for Elizabeth Arden, they reimbursed you up to $5,000 and half the books, along with giving you 3 days off. So I thought, why leave that money and time on the table? Take advantage of everything that the employee was offering, kind of like a 401k or vacation time. So I didn't want to leave that money on the table, and it worked out well. Coming into this MBA program, what I was expecting was going to happen and what I still have to come. I'm a little bit different than everybody else. I'm not done. I'm about halfway through. I have 4 classes left after this semester, so there's still more to come for me. So coming in, what I thought and what did happen were I was speaking to audiences, there was more presentations, there was things like that I expected and did happen through the first half of my MBA course. Another one was the current technology. When I went to my undergrad, even the screen and things like that, and all the technology wasn't available. So getting up to date on current technology and different things, Blackboard, all that didn't exist when I got my undergrad, so it helped me. Also group work, working in group. As I go through my career, group work is very important. This MBA has helped and will continue to help working with different kinds of cultures and diversity and working with different kinds of opinions and types of people. Things that are still to come, I hope, and what I think is still to come, are a lot more of the core accounting classes. My 4 electives, I'll take accounting courses and tax courses, things like that to help with my concentration in accounting. And also the core classes, I still have to take 640 and 641. Those are next year. I've heard those are very rigorous courses, so I'm looking forward to those. If I was running the program, this is a great program. There wasn't many changes I would make. Working full-time, 8 to 6, Monday to Friday, I wish there was more Saturday courses. There was a couple that I took, but said it would help to have a fresh start to the day and not do it after working a 10-hour day. So I would definitely offer more Saturday classes and also more hands-on with the advisors. I've been in this course now 2 years, year and a half. I still haven't even met my advisor. Again, conflict of schedules. So I wish there was a little more hands-on with the advisors and having someone to sit down and go through. But minor changes I would make. The school's been great. I came from Southern, and Sacred Heart has it all over them as far as classes and teachers and what I'm learning. So I'm definitely happy with my choice to come here. Advice I would give to a new MBA student, or if I could go back in time and speak to myself, add some work experience. I would take a break, as I did between my undergrad and grad. I think when you're able to apply to real life situations to what you're learning, it makes a world of difference. So definitely that would be the top one. Get someone else to pay for it, like I did. It's not cheap, it goes up every semester. So I definitely would get an employer or somebody to help pay for it and get the work experience. Enjoy the ride. It's a great goal, a great program. Take a step back and enjoy what you're doing. Any questions?